Do you wish to swear or affirm?
I'll swear.
Okay. Your left hand on the Bible, then you lift up your right hand. Now you say after me. I. Your name, please.
Mrs. Mimi.
Do you hereby swear?
Do hereby swear.
Before this honorable court.
Before this honorable court.
That anything I shall say.
That anything I shall say.
Shall be the truth.
Shall be the truth.
And nothing but the truth.
And nothing but the truth.
So help me God.
So help me God.
My lord, young woman, could you please tell this honorable court your name?
I am Mrs. Mimi.
Where do you stay?
I reside in our compound.
What do you do for a living?
I am the national caretaker elect.
Okay. What do you know about this case of 37 million naira contract?
Mr. Besten took a loan of 37 million naira in the office of the national caretaker to renovate the compound. And instead, he squandered the money.
Oh, you have superimposed yourself as the judge of this case and have found him guilty of this
crime. Objection, my lord! My learned colleague here is already assuming the position of the judge and hereby passing judgment on my client.
No, I never did that. On the contrary, rather it was your client that has stated categorically here before this honorable court.
I basically heard you before the court.
It was your
judgment already.
That you did not advise.
You are already passing judgment on my client before this honorable court.
That he embezzled the money.
Court, you are already passing judgment. She was making a judgment. She was making a judgment.
This is wrong.
Order.
My lord.
Order.
Apologies, my lord.
Apologies.
You may proceed.
Thank you, my lord. Young woman. Has there been at any time before now that my client, Mr. Besten, gave you a contract of renovating the whole compound? Has there been any time like that?
No, there was no time like that. I don't know anything about any contract.
Jesus. Was there any time that you subletted out the job that was given to you by Mr. Besten to someone else to do?
No, there was never a time like that.
Okay. Do you know any woman by the name Ebere residing in the same compound where all of you stay?
I've never heard such name. I don't know anybody named Ebere. I've never even heard that name in my life. I don't know any Ebere.
Well, I want to make you understand the meaning of perjury, young lady. If you're found guilty of perjury in court, it's a crime of its own. My lord, I want to put it straight to this honorable court that this lady in question here does not command the local standard to even in the first place bring my client into questioning. Because she's just a caretaker elect. She has not been confirmed. She has not been sworn in. And she has not even been given any mantle to continue. And there's every tendency that her position could be challenged in a law court that has jurisdiction. So my lord, I want to put it straight to this honorable court that what we are doing here is just a legal exercise which will eventually end up in futility. My lord, at this point, I want to rest my case.
My lord, counsel to the accused is done with a cross-examination. May I discharge her?
Discharge.
And my lord, may we proceed to cross-examination of the witness, Miss Ebere.
You may proceed.
Please, Miss Ebere. Mr. Ebere, do you wish to swear or affirm?
Swear.
Swear. Okay. Your left hand on the Bible. Then you raise your right hand up. Now repeat after me. I. Your name?
Ebere.
Do hereby swear.
Do hereby swear.
Before this honorable court.
Before this honorable court.
That everything I shall say.
That everything I shall say.
Will be the truth.
Will be the truth.
And nothing but the truth.
And nothing but the truth.
So help me God.
So help me God.
My Lord. Madam, could you please tell this honorable court with competent jurisdiction your name?
I'm Ebere.
Where do you reside?
I live in our compound.
Do you know anybody by the name Madam Mimi?
Yes, she's a caretaker elect.
Very good. How do you know her?
She lives in our compound.
Has there been any form of business transaction that took place between the both of you in the most recent past?
Yes.
Could you please tell this honorable court what the transaction is all about?
Besten gave her a contract to renovate the compound and she outsourced it to me.
I have an evidence here that shows that what you just said now is correct. There has been a transaction between you and Madam Mimi. And the contract was signed and some money extended to you for the job. Clerk, please, the evidence I show to you, could you please show to Madam Ebere, let her affirm if she actually signed those documents.
Is that it?
Yes.
My Lord?
My Lord.
Madam Ebere, having affirmed the fact that she's aware of this document and duly signed it alongside Madam Mimi, I want to pray this honorable court to accept this document as an exhibit. It will help us in the realization of this case. My Lord.
This document is admitted in evidence and marked Exhibit A.
And the God visits!
My Lord, at this point, I want to tentatively rest my case, pending when I will be required to prove, in addition to the fact that my client here is actually not guilty of any crime. Thank you, my Lord.
My Lord, we are done with examination of the witness. May I discharge her?
Discharge.
Please.
This honorable court has carefully listened to argument from both sides and deem it expedient for the doctrine of natural justice, equity, and good conscience to be upheld. In the instance case, the court needs a wider legal view on the matter, hence a 5-minute recess. The court will rise.
Court!
Chop by chop, it's not my fault. Them bring the solution, wahala follow and come. This now our politics, yo. Our government, you know they try at all. Nigerian politics don't burn.
National caretaker. But you didn't tell me these things now. You didn't tell me that I'm not supposed to do that.
I should tell
now.
You about your own neighbor. Ebere is supposed to be your neighbor, for God's sake. How would you go ahead to deny your neighbor?
No, I know I had to deny so many things. Eh? I don't know I'm not supposed to deny Ebere.
You have really made this case more strenuous. You had a good case before.
Can you put on that call? No, I want you to tell me on which side are you, Kebran? Why would you support evil?
I don't understand. What is the problem?
No, stop pretending. Don't make me to shout in the court privacy.
Wait, Mimi. So you went in there to tell the judge that I did not give you any contract?
You didn't give me any contract.
Hey! Some people can lie like this. The law, you went there watching her. Tell the judge that I knew you did not give her any contract.
Why would you support evil? You know that Bestent took money in the name of the government. That's 7 million naira. And yet, because you're supporting him, why can't you stand?
You don't represent your matters very well.
You have lost. I gave you contract. You are a liar. You are a big liar. You are a big liar.
I don't like doing the honest thing at last. Because I'm moving to be fine for you, the honest thing at last. What is wrong with you?
But what is wrong with you?
What is wrong with you?
I'm going to take you for your Azul.
I'm going to take you for your Azul. Marty, let me tell you. Let her keep me quiet. Azul, mind yourself. Mind yourself. Put yourself Azul. Put yourself Azul. What am I losing for you? See, you're playing me.
Go and tell my kid.
Counsel to the complainant, do you have any further adumbration for the final address before this court?
Judge, they are stealing my iPhone in this court, oh.
Yes.
Order. This place is not a village square. You are guarded against normal misbehavior. Else, you'll be cited for contempt of court. Counsel, you may proceed.
My lord, it has been proved before this honorable court, beyond reasonable doubt, that my client here is innocent of the crime he's been alleged of. Number two, my lord, Madam Mimi here, that brought about this case, does not have the local standard like I have postulated before now to bring my client to court for any reason, because she is just recently elected and is even yet to be sworn in and given the portfolio to practice as
national caretaker.
National caretaker.
Yes.
So she is just a national caretaker elected as I speak. Having put that, my lord, I want to plead and pray this honorable court to please strike out this case on the ground of lack of merit. Thank you, my lord.
Hi. You are too much. You are too much. Hi.
Counsel, anything?
No, my lord.
After a thorough legal consideration of the matter before this honorable court, I hereby submit that Madam Mimi, as a caretaker elect, has no legal right to sue Mr. Bestent. Therefore, I hereby dismiss this case as it lacks merit.
As the court pleases.
The court will rise.
Court.
Now that Mimi has been whisked away by the law enforcement agencies for her involvement in electoral malpractices, who do you think is supposed to be the national caretaker?
What are you insinuating?
Mr. Azu, you are the duly national elected caretaker. Yes, now, you're forgetting the reason they had to knock you off was because of Mark's alleged involvement into snatching of ballot boxes, of which he has been vindicated. This makes you eligible to uphold your position.
The law! You are making sense! Thank you for reminding me.
Don't forget, I have to still be your legal representative.
Don't worry,
you
I know
take
what
a
to
position.
Do. Don't worry, I know what to do. Huh? Don't worry.
You will do it.
Good day, everybody. Meanwhile, where is Ebere?
It's like she traveled to see her sister.
Okay, Wanyocha.
Yes, yes. Okay. Shout out to see Wanyocha.
First of all, I welcome everybody once again. I called this meeting so I can refresh your mindset on what has played out during the election. On the day of the election,
Mark is confused.
Officer, search Mark's house.
I support you.
Yes,
I support
you. Mark's house.
Judgment.
Why would you talk to
Mark's house?
Why would I not win the election? Why would you let
Mark's house?
No. Why would I not win the election? No, Mark. Why would you have my partnership? Why would I
search his house? Take the officer to search his house.
Everyone, judgment, officer. Everyone should get the search.
Allow them. New people should search my house. I don't have anything. It's foolishness. How can we be winning election and then we will not snatch our own ballot box?
They didn't leave that thing.
Ben suffered identical plumage, but I'm bleeding in similar origin.
Yes, that's the right one.
They know what they have done.
That's the right one.
They know what they have done.
I have to search his house.
I'm taking the ballot out of it. Put off the ballot out of it. I'll take the ballot out of his compound.
Don't worry.
Thief. What are we not talking? What are we not talking? I knew it.
Okay.
Wait. Everybody, wait. Wait, hold on. Where did you see this?
Mark's house.
What are we doing?
Leave me out of me.
Mimi!
Electoral officer, move your machine to the house. Make sure my vote counts. Go and count my vote. Make sure my vote counts. I'm winning the election.
Mimi!
I'm winning the election. We'll keep quiet. I'm winning the election. Everybody knows that I won the election, even the viewers, both online and offline.
Well, the total number of accredited offline voters is 500. Valid number of offline votes is 450. Void is 50. Mimi Power Party, offline vote is 1. Online vote is 217. Base 10 Party, offline vote is 60. Online vote is 3,000 votes. Azu Action Party, offline vote is 339 votes. Online vote is 16,000 votes.
The winner of this election is Mr. Azu of Azu Action Party.
But on the day of my inauguration, something happened.
Excuse me, sir. Good day, ladies and gentlemen.
Good day.
Landlord, Mr. Zhu is not qualified to be the national caretaker.
Why? Hey, what happened?
And who said that? Who are you to talk such nonsense in this meeting? Who invited her? What would even tell? That was the reason you are having meeting with the brand.
Mr. Zhu, calm down.
But I want the lesson.
Calm down. Mr. Azu, calm down.
It was clearly stated that any candidate or party that is involved in any fraudulent activity would be disqualified. And Mark, being the party chairman of Azu Action Party, was found in several fraudulent activities, such as snatching of the ballot box and even kidnapping their opponent, Base 10. For this reason, Mr. Azu should be disqualified. He is not capable to be the national caretaker. Landlord, Mr. Azu defaulted, or is Mr. Azu above the law? Is he above the law?
Mr. Mark defaulted, and his actions indicted Mr. Azu.
How?
And Azu, as the landlord of this compound, your victory is hereby nullified. Yes. And after conferring with the chief electoral officer, I hereby declare the first runner-up, which is Base 10, as the winner of this election.
And that was how I was unjustly disqualified. And now we all know that I'm innocent of the accusation. Even Mark is innocent. And we all witnessed how Mimi was arrested by the members of Nigerian police. Automatically, Mr. Azu is the legitimate national caretaker. By law, I quote. So please, I would want all of you to work with me. And I will say this with my whole heart. I have forgiven everybody. Even Mimi. Even you, Base 10. Yes, I have forgiven everybody. My heart is open. You can come ask for anything. I don't want this my administration to be that of tyranny. I don't want to be hard on anyone. I promise to run a transparent administration like President Muhammadu Buhari.
You know you can be prosecuted for that.
So this is the reason why I called for this meeting to refresh your memory.
Excuse me. I want to ask something. We all here know that Mark is innocent of all the accusations leveled against him. But I'm surprised that nobody is asking about Mark. We all know that by now, Mark is supposed to be here. And still, nobody has asked any question of his whereabouts.
That's true. Hi.
So, where is Mark? Actually, I went to the police station so that I can bail Mark.
Okay.
But on arrival, I heard that Mark has been bailed and he's nowhere to be found.
No! Where do you want to find him again? Mark is nowhere to be found. Where do you want him to be? You want him to come back to this compound? A common criminal! Not a criminal who has been controlling this compound even from the cell. No, who is he coming back to the compound to face? If even he has caught up with him, he cannot step his foot into this compound again. Mark can never. I know he's afraid of me. Perhaps he has heard that I'm the national caretaker. He cannot come back to this compound to face me. Mark can never step his foot into this compound. A common criminal. A criminal who has been tormenting this compound. Don't even get me upset.
Please, as I was saying, I've forgiven everybody. Like, I am not having any grudges against anyone again. Meanwhile, Adin Johnson, I want to remind all of you that landlord will come into the compound any moment to inaugurate me as the national caretaker. Please, I want everybody to cooperate. Okay, I think we'll call the meeting a wrap. I think we've exhausted all the points for today. Adin Johnson, we may stand up and leave. Why are you still sitting? Please stand. We'll rise by lifting orders. My administration will not take that. I wouldn't want anybody to sit down. Please stand. No, we are equal before God and before anybody. Please stand. Yes.
Mr. Azu himself. I hope all is well. Mr. Azu, no way.
Mister. I want the money you borrowed from me.
When?
Can you remember the day?
So the bank wrote to us and they have threatened that if we don't pay back the money in 3 days, that we will go to jail. And we don't want to go to jail. That is why we have come to meet you, to appeal to your conscience, because we know you are a good man and you will listen to us because, you know, we are in your regime. So you can help us and see how you can loan us the money. 500,000 naira. So we can pay the bank people. Then we will now know how to come up with an idea on or a payment plan for you to repay you the money.
Honorable, the reason we have come to meet with you now is because we received the memo from the bank saying that you have cleared off our debt. You need to see the joy in my heart now.
Mr. Su, I thought you said during the meeting that you are forgiving us from everything, like let bygones be bygones and all that. I thought this one should be part of it now.
Listen, can you remember the day I came right this place to ask you for my money? What you said?
Mr. Azu.
I am Bistain and his barrister. I'm here for my money.
Is he talking to us?
How do I know? Mr. Azu, which money?
Let me remind both of you. The money I lend you guys to clear up your debts with the bank.
I laugh in Spanish. Mr. Azu, which money? Which money did you borrow to us? Did you give you any money?
I can't remember.
So I can't even remember you giving any money to anybody here. So why come to accuse us now of being indebted to you?
Bistain and his barrister, enough of this pretense. Please, I want my money right now and here.
We need to understand the characteristics surrounding this money you are demanding of us.
We need to stop speaking that nonsense grammar. What nonsense are you talking about? You guys came to me begging me for money and I lend you guys the money and you are talking nonsense. Please, I want that money now. Nobody will go from here if you don't give me that money. Mr. Luton shouting. Are you afraid of shouting? Everything you are barking, whoa. Are you a dog? Always barking and shouting. Now tell me, when did we come to borrow money from you? What evidence do you have that we came to borrow money from you? Is there any paperwork that we signed? Did we sign anything with you? What's your problem? You only like trouble. You like trouble.
Are you the national caretaker?
Yes. I am now the national caretaker. I am the national caretaker and I want my money.
Mr. Azu, okay, Mr. Azu, can we stick to the to, to the conditions you gave the first time.
Remember, we have an understanding for two of you to serve me for 5 years.
No! I want my money. Mr. All I want is my money.
Mr. So please now. Please.
Mr. I will consider you. I don't want to be a bad leader. I will give you a long time to go and look for the money. But please, I want my money. You can have your whole time. You can have all the time you have in the world to look for my money. But please, I want my money.
Mr. Azu.
Listen, are you stupid? What is this nonsense? Why would you open your mouth to call me Mr. Azu? Have you become mad? What is wrong with you? Listen, did you just call me Mr. Azu? No, you don't have respect for leadership. Listen, when you were a caretaker, was I calling you your name? Did I ever address it? I'm a friend. Why would you open your mouth to call me Mr. Azu? You are very nice to me for saying that. Why would you open your mouth to call me that nonsense? Don't get me upset. Don't ever make me to shout for you. Mister, don't ever make me to raise my voice at you. Because if you do, you won't like me. Don't ever make me angry. Mister, don't ever make me to shout at you again. Hey! Stop the camera, Mister. I want my money.
Mister Azu, was it not just now, about 15 minutes ago, you told me that I should take all the time in the world to pay you back your money. So why are you not asking me of that money?
Bestend, I gave you 15 minutes. And I believe 15 minutes is enough for you to give me my money. What nonsense are you talking? 15 minutes is enough for someone to transfer money from his phone to that account number. No, Bestend, you want to ask me if I'm the national caretaker? Of course I'm the national caretaker. And as a national caretaker, I want my money right here and now.
Mr. Azu, wait till you become the national caretaker. Because for now, you are not the national caretaker.
Oh, you are switching over to another thing. Now, let me show you that I'm the national caretaker and I will not wait. I want my money. You're not going anywhere. Come on, give me my money.
Mr. Azu.
Give me my money.
Mr. Azu.
No, I don't want anything. I don't want to hear anything from you. No, the only thing I want to hear from you is for you to tell me instead to give me my money.
Mr. Azu,
I'm not here to beg you. In fact, this thing that's happening is none of my business.
No, I don't want you to. I don't want to hear anything from you. All I want for you to give me my money.
Mr. Azu, I actually wanted to tell you that your clothes are dry. So you should come and remove it so I can dry my own. Don't worry, I will do that.
My friend, will you come back? What nonsense are you talking about? Are you okay? How can you see I'm two adults trying to fight? All you can say is you want to go and dry. Now go close to that rope. I will cut that rope and cut you. Nonsense. No, is it two adults who wants to fight? You could not even come and separate them. All you want is to go and spray your clothes. No, carry your clothes to that place. I will scatter your pocket and scatter you. Nonsense. I want my money.
Leave me alone. See, you know like the other side of you. Mr. Azu. Hey, Mr. Azu, give me my clothes.
Talking at that door. Who are you?
Good afternoon, sir.
Yes, come down, step down.
Sir, I'm actually looking for the young lady that stays here.
Who are you to look for her? Who are you? Why are you covering your face? Who opened this gate for you? Why would you cover your face to come inside this compound? You're a criminal. You look like a criminal. And I know Max sent you to this compound. But will you take off that nonsense from your face? Let me see your face.
Okay, I don't understand what is wrong with you, but then why are you shouting at me?
Oh! You said I'm shouting! Okay, now let me shout! Let me see if you hear me! You're very, very stupid to open your mouth to talk that nonsense! Why would you even open your mouth to say I'm shouting? You're a fool! You're very stupid! Who are you and what are you looking for the last time?
Please, I don't know whatever is going wrong with you, but that's not my business. I'm looking for Mimi, the young lady that stays here.
Okay, if you must know, Mimi has been arrested. Mimi is facing her crime. Mimi will go to jail. Mimi will go to prison for committing a huge atrocity. I am the national caretaker of this compound.
I don't understand. I don't know if you know the Mimi I'm talking about. I'm just talking about a very calm young lady that stays here. Mimi, yes.
If you cannot hear me now, I want to ask you, who are you to her?
I'm a... Which police station again, please?
I said, who are you to her?
I'm Mimi's, never mind. Just tell her I came looking for her.
You are a fool for saying that nonsense. You are Mimi, never mind. Tell you, who are you? You are frustrated. You look like those criminals who came from Lagos. Those boys who make you are frustrated. No, you came all the way from Lagos. If I'm sure that you come from Lagos, to come and live with woman in Obibo. If Lagos are frustrated, you go back to Lagos. You come to live with woman in Obibo. My friend, lock that gate for me and get out. Nonsense.
Gentlemen, you're welcome.
Thank you, sir.
After painstakingly observing your electioneering campaign for who becomes my national caretaker and the ultimate brouhaha that followed it with a lot of bitterness and rancor, I discovered that actually Mr. Azu was innocent of the accusations leveled against him. Even Mark, that was his electionary manager, was also innocent. Because it was discovered that Mimi actually stole the ballot box and planted it in Mark's house. I was really disillusioned and I was not happy with what had been happening in my compound. And for that, I decided to appoint an acting national caretaker.
Come on, come on.
Mark, you're welcome. You're welcome. You're welcome.